Well, we are thrilled to welcome another family and one that has started multiple generations of visits to Ocean's Reach. And you have a great story to tell. But the biggest story right now is that you're here on Ocean's Reach to celebrate a very, very, very momentous event. And Linda, I'm going to ask you to share what brought you to Ocean's Reach and what you have planned for everybody that's here in your party.
I'm Linda, and it's actually my brother, Brian. His daughter, his third daughter, is getting married down here in a couple days. So, and her fiancé is from Scotland. So we have a group, too, coming from Scotland who they've never been by the ocean or in heat. So this is all new for them. So that's the reason why the whole family is here. But this is the first time we've all been together for overnight anywhere. And to be together in Sanibel, from we were in Sanibel decades ago at Periwinkle Trailer Park. And I'm going to, Brian can talk about that.
We came over in the 60s. Not sure which, it was the year after the causeway went in. After they stopped using the coming across in the boat. Stayed at Periwinkle Way, what was it, camping park at the time? Yeah. Campgrounds at the time. And stay there many years, come here, typically came here at Easter time. And later on, I actually honeymooned here and camped in a tent and was told that I was not doing the right thing by my bride. But she had a wonderful time. We stayed at the park there. I had been there as a teenager. The owners had let us stay there, which he had never done before because our family had been there so many years. He let a bunch of teenagers stay there. We had a great time. Later on, we ended up coming to Ocean's Reach. I had done a project for a lady, Vicki Ashton, and we ended up staying in her 1A1 right down by the pool there. And so our kids got used to coming to Sanibel here as well. So that's a brief nutshell of what's going on at Sanibel and the stayed at a number of places all around, but always come back to Ocean's Reach.
I'm going to say one more thing. I was here for my first honeymoon here with my late husband. We were down at another spot, so that was some 30 years ago, too. And so I hadn't been here basically since. So
I don't have a lot of recollection of being here other than because I was in grade school, but I do remember a couple things. When we came down, my first day out, I got sunburned. And we were in this trailer, and I was on the top bunk, which wasn't a lot of air up there, and just being miserable. But I do remember walking down to the beach and just being in awe of the sand dunes, the white sand, and the periwinkle. And so we're glad to be back and to see some of the changes that have taken place here.
Your kid, you pick up every single shell on the beach, and they, in fact, we still probably have them in boxes at home. But in those days, every once in a while, a live one would sneak in, and by the time you got about halfway back to Illinois, you remembered that there was still one in the back there because it got a little stinky in the car. I remember in 1A1, Ocean's Reach here, we had Christmas. And for us, it's very different down here for Christmas, coming from the Midwest. And the girls just really needed a tree and something to look like Christmas, so we found a sea pine, big sea pine branch that had washed up on shore and turned it into a Christmas tree and had it in the lanai or the screened-in porch area there and put lights on it, and everybody that came along the pool and up the path really got a kick out of that, I think.
Have you told them about the alligators, the wonderful alligators here?
Now, they have rules now on the island, which is a good thing, but in the old days, used to feed alligators, and they love Wonder Bread. Because it has vitamins and minerals in it, so the Wonder Bread was great at the time. But don't feed them now; it's a $500 fine, I think.
Maybe you could just share a little bit about where you live now, and some of the activities that you're involved with when you're not vacationing on the beach.
Okay, I live actually on Gages Lake in Illinois. This is near in between Chicago and Milwaukee. We call it a city lake, but we can still have all four season sports there. So I like the water. Doesn't matter if it's a lake or on the ocean. So that's why it's really special to be down here. And my husband works as a photographer at Great Lakes. And we're very involved in our church. And we're very involved, where you're going to hear about here, about the camp program. We try to be up there. And we have a new grandbaby, so we're involved there too and enjoy.
Lynn and I are from Crystal Lake, Illinois, about 50 miles northwest of Chicago, and I'm a project manager, builder by trade, developer, and my passion, I'm on the board and I work at a children's camp, Lake Geneva Youth Camp and Conference Center up in Wisconsin. So I always like to be near the water.
Well, this is just finished my 15th year at Lake Geneva Youth Camp and Conference Center, and it's been a great place. I do very similar to what Drew does in welcoming guests and getting them opportunities to get away from all the distractions and city life so that they can enjoy being by the lake and being together. We have close to 12,000 guests that come a year, as well as a summer youth camp with about 1,200 children that come. So we're a year-round facility and just enjoy working with people. But I gotta tell you, it's nice to get away, and this is my little bit of downtime to just be able to relax and enjoy the ocean and the family.
Lastly, are there any tips that you can provide future guests of Ocean's Reach for planning their vacation or their special event, and how it can be special for them? What have you learned?
Pack less. You really are still only going to be in a couple outfits, so you don't have to pay that extra $15 on the airplane. You can pack less. You're just really in your swimsuit or your shorts, and everybody is very accommodating here to help you. Whether it's a wedding plans or a family reunion, and all you have to do is ask. And just remember, we're in a little bit of a kickback time here. It's more laid back than what you're perhaps used to, and so that's a good thing. That's a very good
plan
thing.
Plan on bringing your binoculars and some good memory cards for your cameras, because it's just stunningly beautiful down here. In fact, I'm sitting here looking up at an osprey nest right behind the garden patio here, and there's a little fledgling looking around for its parents, apparently. But Ding Darling Reserve, just a great place for the kids, and spent a lot of time out there seeing all the animals and the birds. Just lots to do, and you can literally spend months here and never probably eat at the same restaurant, I would think.
Well, we've only just arrived, so don't know a lot yet, but my first impression, obviously looking online on the website and everything, very good, very well laid out, but I'm probably a little bit more old school. I like the personal touch, and I think that's what I appreciated with Drew. She was, when I called, she was there, and I was able to help us with making some little changes, and I think that's, for me, that's what's most important, is to be able to get a hold of somebody and talk to them live. So that's what I really appreciate.